Welcome back to another Sunday. Welcome back to Cocktail Book Day, my friends. Yes, another book, another Sunday, another cocktail. It's the way how we roll on this channel. So, today the book, maybe not so excited for some people in a first look, but for me it's kind of a whole sentimental feelings. Okay, let's put it this way. The book which I talk today is The World Encyclopedia of Cocktails by Paul Martin. Now, Paul Martin, it's back in the days, let's put it this way, in the 90s, when I start with the bartending and when I start discovering the cocktails and the whole world of the mixology, there wasn't much literature or let's say books or information about these things back in Bulgaria. So slowly when things start evolving, we start getting books and start getting involved with, you know, the world of the mixology. And this was one of my first books, not the one which I showed you a few videos ago when I started this series. That was my first book, but this one also was one of my first books. And Paul Martin, it's a UK bartender. At the time, he was huge. I mean, I don't know how big it was in the world of bartending here in UK because I was back in Bulgaria, but for us it was a name. And when he released this book, I was really impressed of it because the book, it's put proper like in a bartending manner, let's put it that way. But it's made very easy to read and very easy to follow for also home bartending. So Paul Martin decided to do this book and kind of introduce the world of cocktails and mixology in a very simplicity and very like an easy way for everybody to follow, bartenders to prove their skills and home enthusiasts to discover the world of the cocktails. The book, it's a wonderful read. You have I don't know how many chapters it's around, but let's say chapter 1, it starts with aperitif, then you have chapter 2 with the spirits, chapter 3 it's with a different cocktails, starting with traditional, long, short, blended, direct cocktail, and so on and so forth. You get the idea, yeah? So basically the first, I think, around, how many it is? Yeah, around 50 pages. It's all about cocktails, about different styles of spirit. It's basically explaining in the very easy way for everybody to understand what they're drinking. And then it's settled in a different chapters to give you the option to try a different styles of cocktails like traditional or classics, then blended cocktail, long drink, short drink, shooters, diary cocktail, obviously if you want to introduce some milk and creams to your cocktail and all this kind of stuff. As you can see, my book have lots of paper marks here, which is cocktails I will be presenting on this channel. I'm going slowly through them because even it's an old book. It was released in 97, so it's not that old, but it is old. Some of the cocktails inside, if not most of them, still standing to these days, and a very good base for you to start experimenting and discovering flavors and understanding the difference between like a short or long drink or a blended or diary cocktail and all this kind of a terminology, which it's gonna help you. Definitely is gonna help you. It's a good piece of book to have on your shelves. It's not a waste at all. It's a fantastic, fantastic, well done presented book. So this is what we're doing today. I will be doing two cocktails from the book. And now I wanted to do something, whatever, kind of a, like a pick something randomly, but I wanted to introduce to you to a spirit and a liqueur which it's not very popular sadly, and this is the Drambuie. So the Drambuie, it's a fantastic liqueur based on aged whiskey with the heather honey, herbs and botanicals. It's a wonderful liqueur, sadly not that very popular, and I don't know why, but looking through this book I understand why, to be honest. Thank you very much. Thank you. So yes, Drambuie, a wonderful, a beautiful liqueur, aged Scotch whisky, heather honey, herbs and spices. And as I mentioned, I kind of get the idea why it's not very popular. First of all, it's our fault as bartenders. Cheers, by the way. Beautiful. But second, looking through my books, I didn't find many recipes. And in recent years, even if you look on internet, you won't find that much choice of recipes like with most of the other liqueurs or spirits. And a few weeks ago, I was guest on a 60 seconds cocktail with Vino Valentino. And yes, Vino Valentino, it's a wonderful chap, New York City baby, and he invited me on his channel to talk about bartending, about YouTube, about everything. And then he asked me a question, my favorite cocktail, and I said Rusty Nail. And if you are familiar with Drambuie, this is probably the most famous, if not the most famous cocktail with Drambuie. Saying that, I will leave a link in the description, and obviously, I want you to go and check Vino, because apart from doing this fantastic pub crawl, YouTube pub crawl, when it's inviting other YouTube bartenders and enthusiasts and home bartenders for an interview, he's making fantastic cocktail and it's a wonderful person. So I want you to go and check them. Do me a favor, go check the channel and subscribe, because he's a wonderful chap, he deserves it, okay? But yeah, we talk about the Rusty Nail, and that's what got me thinking. I'm probably gonna bring the Drambuie back to my channel like more and more with my own recipes and recipes which I kind of gather from different places. Today I'm not gonna make my recipe because obviously we talk about the book from Paul Martin and we're gonna do cocktails included in the book. And also in the future episodes and videos, I will introduce Drambuie with my own cocktails. But I think that's so much to say for now, without wasting too much time. And yeah, let's go behind the bar and make these two cocktails. Okay guys, so cheers again. I'm gonna enjoy my Drambuie neat or on the rocks, because it's just wonderful. But yes, we're gonna make two cocktails today, very simple, because no matter what I look, it seems like most of the cocktails with Drambuie, it's very traditional and very simple with a few ingredients, two or three ingredients. And I understand why, because the Drambuie, it's a very prominent in a flavor and a very unique in a character. You have the aged whiskey, but it's very mild and hidden under the herbs and botanicals, and especially the heather honey. Heather honey, it's a, I don't know in your neck of the wood if you have heather honey, but it's a traditional and very popular in Scotland, and it's one amazing honey. I love using it in the cocktail, and made with this liqueur inside, like combined with the whiskey and with the herbs, and it's producing something absolutely fantastic. So we talk about the Rusty Nail, another cocktail which is familiar to the Rusty Nail. It's a Aberfoyle. Aberfoyle, it's basically replacing the whiskey in the Rusty Nail with the vodka. So it's pretty much the same. I will have notes here because I can't remember all these pages. So let me just go first to the Aberfoyle just to tell you what about it is. It's very simple. It's basically 3 ounces of vodka and 2 ounces of Drambuie. So it's a fairly strong cocktail, okay? But it's a wonderful, if you like vodka and if you want to experience the full flavor of the Drambuie, that's the perfect way to do it, because the vodka obviously doesn't hold that much flavor. So the Drambuie is gonna shine fantastically. The next cocktail is Adam and Eve, number 2, which is kind of weird, because I look and there's so many Adam and Eve and they're like totally different to each other, but probably the most famous is the original one, which is a cognac forbidden fruit liqueur and a gin. But then the Adam and Eve number 2 here, it says gin, Drambuie, amaretto and dash of grenadine. Then I found another Adam and Eve online, which is totally different ingredients, so we're not gonna go there. I want to prepare for you a two cocktail. One is called Drambuie, which is a fairly good name for the Drambuie, and the other one is called Dunny, So we're gonna go on page 95 and 96 and we're gonna start with a Drambuie, which is 2 ounces of Drambuie. Now I'm following the book, as always, here it's everything in ounces. You're gonna find the recipe down below in the description in milliliters and ounces as well. So don't get stressed, it'll be everything done for you to make it at home. So the Drambuie, it's 2 ounces Drambuie, 1 ounce scotch, and dash creme de cassis. So let's make it. It says shake and strain. And I understand why it says shaken, because the Drambuie, it's quite heavy and sweet. So you wanna bring some airiness and some dilution to the cocktail to lower down, because end of the day, it's, I think it's, yeah, 40 ABV. So let's start making this one before wasting too much time. But if you're new to the channel and if you're still with me, I want to apologize for the long videos, but this is how it's rolling on Sunday. We're not rushing, we're doing long video because it's all about the book, about the spirit, and I want to give you a little bit more knowledge about these things, okay? Scotch whiskey, I'm gonna grab my JB, and we need a creme de cassis, which I have this wonderful feel from Cartoon, Joseph Cartoon, but use your cassis. So 2 ounces of Drambuie. So we're gonna go with the 60 ml. Is that 60 ml? Yeah. It's a fairly strong cocktail. It's a boozy cocktail. It's a slow sip, so you have to be careful. Don't push too much. It's not a fast drink. It's an enjoyable, slow drink, okay? Behave, please. Drink responsibly. Responsibly. Does it say it like that? Yes, it is says like that. So 30 ml of scotch and a dash of creme de cassis liqueur. So I'm just gonna drop a dash or a little bit more. That's it, that'll be enough. Grab some ice. See, the beauty of these cocktails, especially with the Drambuie, it's you don't need any garnish. They are cocktails, old style cocktail. They are made to be enjoyed and sipped. It's not about the garnish, it's about the liquid inside. And it's about the flavors. If you fancy to do a garnish, go for it. But no need one, okay? Wonderful. Gonna grab a glass. And we will serve. Oh, I've changed the position of my strainers. So I'm gonna have some blind moments like that. Now I'm gonna serve this over a nice chunk of clear ice. And this is your cocktail. I know it's gonna sound like, whoa, this is gonna be a boozy thing. And I think here I need to mention Carl from the Alchemix bar. He's a big fan of Drambuie. So Carl, this is for you, my friend. Hopefully you're gonna enjoy. And you guys, don't forget, down in the description, Alchemix bar, I'll leave the link to his channel. Go and check. It's a wonderful channel. Another friend on YouTube, which I have to mention, because I like what he's doing and I hope you're gonna go and give it a check, and why not subscribe? You'll learn something different than what I'm giving you here, okay? Cheers! Ooh. Definitely a boozy, slow sipper drink. Definitely need to sit down, enjoy after meal, so you definitely, yeah, definitely you need to eat before that. Don't go on empty stomach with this drink. You need to have a strength, because it's a wonderful as a drink. It's not strong to drink, it's not unpleasant. It's a beautiful combination, but you can feel it's a strong. So it's gotta be slow drinking, okay? Traditional cocktails back in the days, people like drinking proper. They don't wanna joke around, okay? So I'll leave this here. So this is the Drambuie, and we're gonna make the other one, which is Dunny. Now Dunny, it's Drambuie, it's a single malt whiskey or Isle Mild whiskey and a dash of lime juice. So let's do that. And built in the old-fashioned glass. So there's nothing like a difficult here, just straight away in an old-fashioned glass. So we're gonna get a matching glass and let's build it. 1 ounce or a 30 ml of your Drambuie. Beauty. I'm gonna use for this a Talisker. Obviously, you use whatever single malt you have. I have quite few, but I'm gonna use the Glenmore. I think it's gonna work better with that because, definitely it's gonna work better. It's a single malt scotch. It's not that prominent on peat and smokiness, so I think it's gonna pair fantastic with a Drambuie here. Here we go. What we have here, by the way, it's the same. So it's 1 ounce, 30 ml, following the book again. So you basically have 2 ounces. That's a slow sip again, but it will be more kind of a short drink, not much hassle about it, okay? And we have a fresh lime juice. So we're gonna squeeze fresh lime juice. Let's get here. This should be enough for me. So it says dash of lime juice. So how do you measure dash of lime juice? Let's just squeeze some. A little bit more. This should be absolutely enough. And because it's served directly in the glass, you can put a big cube of ice. I will serve it over a few kind of a big pieces of ice. Give it a good stir. You want to mix the drink, you want to dilute it a little bit, you want to make sure the juice is mixed with the ingredients, and of course, because it's a Drambuie, you have a honey, it's more sweet, you want to give them a good stir, okay? Basically until the glass starts steaming outside. That does the right way to say it. Okay, and here we are. Now, because it's with lime, it doesn't say anything about garnish, but I would love to kind of I know what I'm gonna do. Just a small, like a button of lime, gonna squeeze it and just gonna drop inside. And this is it, the Dunny cocktail with Drambuie as well from the Paul Martin book, World Encyclopedia of Cocktails. I'm so bad with name of books, I'm sorry. Oh, you see now between these two, I think that's mine. I mean, both of them is fantastic, but this is a little bit pushing on the edge. When here the balance is fantastic. It's 50-50 basically, Drambuie and malt whiskey, and with this a little touch of lime juice, it brings so much nice freshness. It's like, you know, lime and honey works beautifully. Now whoever made this cocktail, he knows what he's doing. All right guys, this is it from me for today. I hope you enjoy this Sunday. I hope you kind of getting to the book vibe and you're gonna go and check some books. I don't want you to just go and buy them just because I'm telling you. I want you to really desire to learn something and have them on your shelves, because just staying there taking the dust, you know, collecting the dust, it's no point. But if you really want to ask me any questions about the books and anything, you know, leave a comment, share the video, like it. Don't forget to check Vino channel 60 seconds cocktail. Don't forget to check Carl from the Alchemix Bar channel. I'll leave links in the description, of course. And don't forget to go and grab a bottle of Drambuie if you never try one, or if you want to experience the beautiful flavor of this liqueur and you want to know more about it. Don't be shy, go and grab a bottle and you're gonna love it. And make sure you subscribe, because I'm gonna make some more cocktails with the Drambuie, so you know how to drink it. We're gonna create some lovely long drinks with the juices and maybe some tiki drinks. Yes, Drambuie and tiki drinks, why not? Trust me, Drambuie and coconut works fantastic, but we'll talk about this in different videos. For now, enjoy your rest of the day, whatever you're doing, and I'll see you in another video regularly Thursday and Sunday back for a cocktail book day. Until then, as always, I love you and I leave you. Bye bye.